Father, for this very, very special time, for Kate and Andrew, we're just so thankful to be part of it. And we're thankful for the fact that you brought them together. Their meeting was not by accident or by happenstance. You knew from the day that they were born, they were going to be with others, with each other. So as we enjoy this time of celebration, we just ask you to be a deep, deep part of it. Don't let us take one moment to know that you are not here. In everything we do and say, everywhere we go, we want to honor you. In Christ's name we pray, amen.
Welcome to rehearsal dinner. When I think of Andrew, I think of humility and selflessness. And I think a lot of his friends in this room will tell you that Andrew is a very great friend because he thinks of others before he thinks of himself. My wife is a prayer warrior, and she's been praying for Kate for probably the last 20 years, and here she is. And that's the truth, and it does pay off. And so, Kate, we're so proud of you and love you so much, and we love your family. And Jay and Janie, we love you so much.
Andrew, you have chosen well. I expect you. She is now your problem and not mine. I expect you to love Kate and to cherish Kate. I expect you to protect Kate and to watch over her. Kate, you have chosen well. And I expect you to love Andrew and to cherish Andrew, and you protect him.
He is always going to be the person I look up to with all of these things. And now we're at another milestone. Here we are at a wedding. You found someone, and that is something that I look up to you for. And I want to find someone just like that. I want to find something that you guys have, and I really am excited to find it. And I'm so happy that you found it. Kate, I love you. I never had a sister. I don't know how to have a sister. And I am so, so happy that you're a part of our family now because you fit in like no one else. And I love you. And Andrew, I love you too.
Andrew, or son, as I like to call him since I don't have one. We love having you as part of our family. And we love your family. We have just loved getting to know y'all. I can't believe all these years we lived so close and we never knew y'all. So it's such a blessing. You are a young man of such strong character. You love and honor your family. You love Kate. You love Jesus. And most importantly, when the really big decisions have to be made, and I'm speaking of when Angela and I and Kate and Andrew went to Gainesville for them to find a house. So when the really big decisions have to be made, you employ a spreadsheet. And so you have stolen my heart. Y'all are a beautiful couple. You have the blessing of a new family, your family ahead of you. So prayers answered. A toast to the future, Mr. and Mrs. Bowman.
From Kate, I am positive I will learn how to be the best wife possible because I know that's what she will be to Andrew. And lastly, Andrew, you have proven me wrong. And I say that because I've spent the majority of my life wondering if anyone would ever be good enough for my big sister. But here you are, and I am so excited and so thankful to have you as part of our family and to be able to call you a big brother. Thank you for treating my sister so well. You are one lucky guy. I'm so happy for you guys, and I love you both so much.
I think it was second date for with Kate. And he walks in and goes, hey, how are you? I'll go, good, how was it? And he goes, oh, I think I want to marry her. It's like, wow. It's like, oh, wow. And ever since then, I knew he was right. And he told me that night, I think I want you to be our best man. It was really cool.
So background of me and Kate, I actually drove Kate to school every single day for all of junior year of high school, as well as I think about half of senior year of high school. I know she wasn't allowed to drive to high school for a while, so that was a big victory when that was sold in. But as I mentioned, Kate is celebrating there in the highs when either of our crushes would look our way in high school. We would jam out to Taylor Swift in the car, stop at a stoplight, get out, dance as loud as we can until someone noticed or the light turned green, get back in the car, and keep going. So I always have so many of those fun memories celebrating those little highs.
As people have pointed out, Andrew is very humble, so much so to the point that you know that Andrew hates sitting here listening to people compliment him over and over and over and over again. And he's getting red now just because I said that. But Andrew really is one of the most humble people that I know. Andrew is somebody that is just so talented and so smart, so intellectual, and just pretends like he's not and acts like it's just kind of run of the mill, like that's not something noteworthy, you know?
I really don't know either of y'all that well, but you have raised two people that are so, so dear to me. And it's a huge testament to y'all and to your marriages and to your families that you have these two great kids. Thank you for everything this weekend, but thank you for raising two kids that have loved me so well. Okay, I will circle back to where I started with Bowman with some complicated math. So these are based on legitimate calculations, so feel free to come check my math. But the chances of Kate marrying a boy that she overlapped with at Highland Park are 1,250, which is 0.08%. Okay, so not high. 0.08%. The chances of emailing Lone Star Southern and coming out a bridesmaid are 1 in 12,000, which is 0.008%. So I'm thrilled you're getting married, and I'm really thrilled you answered my email. Cheers to the Bowmans.
With this ring, I marry you. And seal the promise. Of my love and faithfulness. In the name of the Father. The Son. And the Holy Spirit. Andrew, Kate, now, by the authority of God and His Word, and in accordance with the laws of this state, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss your bride.
over.